गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर किरण पोद्दार, अंगड़ी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, बेलगावी. इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इनवर्स लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ लॉगरिथम फंक्शंस. इफ एनी लॉगरिथम फंक्शन इज गिवन एंड इफ इट इज बीन टोल्ड टू ऑब्टेन इनवर्स लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म, देन वी नीड टू अडॉप्ट दिस मेथड विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नाउ. सो इफ f bar of s is given and if we apply Laplace inverse on this, then what happens? If you apply Laplace inverse on this f bar of s, it is a known concept which will be equal to f of t. If you recall, we have a derivative property. What it says? If we are finding Laplace transform of t raised to n into f of t, which will be equal to minus 1 raised to n into d raised to n by ds raised to n into f bar of s, or else we can take it as minus 1 raised to n into this. If you take, it is nothing but f bar dash in the sense a derivative. Okay. A derivative. I'll take one case here. If n is equal to 1, then what happens? Laplace transform of t into f of t, which will be equal to minus 1 raised to 1 into d by ds of f bar of s. Fine. In this case, if you see, which will be equal to minus 1 raised to 1 will be equal to minus 1. Fine. Then this d by ds of f bar of s can be treated as f bar dash of s. If this is a Laplace transform, if you send it to the other end, then it becomes Laplace inverse of minus f bar dash of s is equal to t into f of t. This is a very important result which will help us to obtain Laplace transformation of logarithm functions. I'll just take a note and I'll tell you how the flow will be. Keep this result in a mind to solve the examples, then how best we can utilize this to obtain a result. Assume if f bar of s is given, f bar of s is given, then what to do? Apply logarithm on both sides. Okay, after applying logarithm, we will be getting its result. Then if you see this, we have f bar of s, but we need f bar dash of s. So what to do? Differentiate with respect to s to obtain f bar dash of s. Okay, then what to do? F bar dash of s is there, but we need that along with minus sign. Then what to do? Then we need to take it as f bar dash of s along with minus. Then apply inverse Laplace transform, that is nothing but inverse Laplace transform of this f bar dash of s is equal to t into f of t. So this will be the solution. Fine. So let us solve a few examples to understand this concept. So I'll be taking one example to make it very simple and make it clear. Let us take one example. The example says, find inverse Laplace transform of the function, logarithm function. For example, it is logarithm of s plus a divided by s plus b. Fine. So how to obtain the solution?
just go through this flow, then you will understand the solution.
Directly I'll be writing the result, which is already discussed. We have Laplace inverse of minus f bar dash of s is equal to t into f of t. Fine, for our reference. Let us consider the given thing as f bar of s, which is nothing but logarithm of s plus a divided by s plus b, and apply logarithm property on this. You can see f bar of s is there, apply logarithm property. If you apply logarithm property, it becomes log of s plus a minus log of s plus b, which is nothing but f bar of s. Then differentiate that with respect to s. Okay, differentiate this result with respect to s, then it becomes f bar dash of s is equal to differentiation of log of s plus a. Log of s plus a will be equal to 1 divided by s plus a minus differentiation of log of s plus b is equal to 1 divided by s plus b. Then after this, what to do? Apply minus sign on both sides. Minus sign. Then it becomes minus f bar dash of s is equal to, if you apply minus on both sides, then shuffling a term, it becomes 1 divided by s plus b minus 1 divided by s plus a. Okay, then after applying minus sign, we need to apply inverse Laplace transform. Then apply inverse Laplace transform on both sides. Inverse Laplace transform of minus f bar dash of s, which is equal to inverse Laplace transform of 1 divided by s plus b minus 1 divided by s plus a. Fine. Then as per this equation, if I call it as equation number 1, then from equation number 1, we will be getting a result. That result says, from equation number 1, Laplace inverse of f bar dash of s is equal to t into f of t, which is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus b minus Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus a. Fine. Then t into f of t is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 divided by s plus b is nothing but e raised to minus bt. Since 1 divided by s plus b means raised to minus b, minus second one will be e raised to minus at. Okay. Therefore, our intention is to obtain inverse Laplace transformation, which is nothing but obtaining f of t. Therefore, f of t is equal to e raised to minus bt minus e raised to minus at divided by